16 playables right now. And we're probably going to get, like, maybe two more out of this pack. Huh, the Laps did well, but the Rock's Bodyguard did. I still would rather have Rock's Bodyguard than Scattershot Archers, I'm afraid. Even with Ranger of Yos, I'm not going to take Scattershot Archers over a card that I'm going to main deck. Bodyguard helps with Exalted, like, stacking a bunch of Exalted guys, and with the two Stewards casting on turn four, like, going, you know, turn two Steward, turn three, like, Meditant, turn four Bodyguard. It's pretty reasonable. All right, Laps. Anyway, oh wow, the Sylvan Bounty did come around. Tukatun Fallon to make our Ranger better, or Sylvan Bounty? Gotta go with the Sylvan Bounty. Surprising that came around when Flip Cards didn't. Ash's Favor. So, our Ranger's got a Lonely Nicoddle to get. Yeah, that's okay. Let's see. Karthus, Tyrant of Jund, and a bunch of insane red-green cards. Well, so I'm not going to take Karthus that doesn't fit with the deck at all and is like double splash. On the other hand, some of these red-green cards are pretty good. Like, Jund Hackblade we can rule out. Naya Hushblade, obviously, is the card that's the easiest for us to cast. Vengeful Rebirth is probably not going to be too good, especially with our low-curve deck. On the other hand, I'm pretty sure I'm taking Bloodblade off here. I can Land Cycle the Sylvan Bounty. I've got an Eye Panorama. And yeah, Bloodblade Elf's pretty insane. I've only got one miss right now, which is Lapse of Certainty, but everything else I hit, I'm pretty happy with, so yeah. Plus, if we're lucky, the Nine Hunchblade a wheel. I've definitely seen it happen before, because jeez. So, another pretty good red-green card versus a Naya Hushblade. Sadly, Bituminous Blast is just not castable, although it's very, very good. I wonder what the guy to our left took over it, because it should be in Jund, based on what we're casting. So again, it's Naya Hushblade versus Spellbreaker is really what it comes down to. Again, Spellbreaker's only got one red mana in his cost, and predict, so we'll play a few mountains. See, right now I've got only a couple red cards. Yep, I guess the red cards keep coming, but this time there's a Kosali Pride Mage. Colossalmite's very, very good, and I definitely don't mind having it, but Pride Mage is much easier to cast, and it's also very good, so there's been a lot of red-green coming, which means a reasonable chance of wheeling a couple of these cards. I'm not too unhappy about. Alright, so we've got Trace of Abundance, which will help splash the red cards, but I'm not too excited about that. I think I'd rather have the white-green border post. It also fixes our mana and isn't going to slow us down as much as like Trace would. Take my 2-drop Accelerant and rather be Steward of Malron. Alright, we're not going to be able to pass up Colossalmite here, since certainly not going to take Naya Sojourners or Grizzled Leotow over it. Colossalmite is just so absurd. End up splashing a few more cards than I would have liked, but I think the cards were taken good enough that it'll probably work out. Huh. Let's see if anything we're particularly interested in playing here. God Tracker is not even going to be good enough. We've only got 2 5 power guys. It's not anything we really care about playing against. I guess we could take Veinfire Border Post. There's a very, very small chance we'll end up playing with it. Alright, well, we've got Sigil Captain, but it doesn't actually do anything for us, since we've only got like, 2 actual 1-1s, the Squire and the Sighted Case Sorcerer. Mikado's not actually going to be a 1-1. On the other hand, the Trace it will help us splash our red cards. So Well, we definitely have enough playables now. Got 26, but one's Nine Panther and one's Wildfield Mortar Post, so should be okay. This deck's looking like a 16 land deck because we've got two Stewards, a Trace, and a Land Cycler. Alright, Leonard Armor Guard is always solid. Von Elbert's actually pretty good too, but more so in like a red green deck because it's not exactly a splash card. And Armor Guard does a pretty good job of letting you get in. Alright. Question is, between Violent Outburst and Sarah on your lane, which red card would be more likely to splash? Probably the Outburst, although I don't really think we're going to play either of these cards. Now, if that Colossal Might could wheel, that would be something else. Sigil Captain, still probably not playing it, but I don't think we're playing multiple Violent Outbursts either. We do have a couple guys at pumps. These are all cards we're fairly unlikely to make the cut. Don't think we're playing Catherine Summit either, but I don't really like to play against it. Sentinar is a decent card. It's pretty annoying to play against. Pretty happy with this deck. It's certainly beat downs. Brainbite's a better card than Sojourners, but Brainbite's not going to be very good against us, whereas the Sojourners, I guess, is like a random blocker. So might as well take the card. Plus, getting two life turns are actually good against this deck, so I'd rather not face down the Heather Rock page. Nothing particularly insane wheeled, but I didn't really expect them to. But there's a chance, but Colossal Might or Vithian Renegade's wheeling is probably a little too much to ask for. Let's build this deck. I wonder if I would have played a Tuca Tongue Thalid with a Sigil Captain. That would have been kind of sweet, but overall I think all the cards we took over to Tuca Tongue Thalid, definitely better. The corner case of being able to Ranger for it is cute, but I just don't see that happening. Would have been nice if one of those Naya Hush Blades wheeled, because that's not that much to ask for, but I guess I'm not too surprised that they didn't. For now, I'm not going to start the Gluttonous Slime, because it just doesn't seem that insane. Definitely running Sylvan Bounty, despite Land Cycles not being exactly what you want in this sort of deck. Gleam is pretty insane, it's really nice and aggressive, but Sylvan Bounty not quite so much. Trace is coming in. Got a couple misses with our Cascade, but just hope we don't hit them, I guess. We've got a ton of low drops, so it's going to be easy to not miss, but there is a Border Post, a Trace, and a Worst of All Laps. I don't think we're going to start the Violent Outburst, since it doesn't really help us that much. No reason to play Vadefire Border Post. So not counting the Wildfield Border Post, since it's the land. We've got 24 spells here. Just looking at our mana cost. Oh yeah, we can definitely run 16 land with Trace, two Stewards, a Land Cycler, and then like only one actual 6 drop and one 5 drop. Wish I could run 15, but there's nothing I really want to play over the last land anyway. Yeah. This should be fine. Another real question is how many mountains. I think so. 2 mountains will give us 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 red sources, which is certainly enough for our 3 red cards. And then, let's see. 6-6-2 is pretty much what I was thinking. That gives us 8 green, 8 white, and then with the Sylvan Bounty, it's Well, maybe it's possible with Sylvan Bounty and Trace, which both fix white. We could go one more green than white. Like 7, 5. Because that way we have 9 green and then 5, 6, 7, kind of 9 white. So that should be good. Plus, we want to cast her in the card on turn 1. So. Alright, we'll do it. I guess all that's left is to battle, which we'll get to in the next video.